All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Oliver Friesen. He is the CEO of Guardian Metal Resources. And Oliver, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm doing well, Steve. I'm actually from Vancouver originally, so it's good to see you in my hometown there.
Nice, nice. Well, we got you in New York today at our OTC studios, so it's good to have you along. And we'll talk about why you're there in just a second. But first, tell me a bit about the company itself and Guardian.
Yeah, of course. So we actually are a UK listed, our main board, so our main listing is in the UK on the AIM segment there. We're now just recently upgraded our US listing to the OTCQX. But we are a Nevada focused company. You know, our kind of main objective is really on the onshoring and reshoring of critical metal supply chains back onto US soil. So our main asset, our kind of focal point is the Pilot Mountain project, which is the largest undeveloped tungsten deposit on U.S. soil. And there's a really interesting and growing narrative around tungsten in particular and the importance for U.S. national security. So we're U.S., our UK-based company, but we're really looking to now kind of push the narrative and grow our presence here in the U.S.
Yeah, talk to me a bit about tungsten, because people may not understand the importance of tungsten and why it's such a critical metal.
Yeah, of course. So tungsten, you know, 3 years ago when we first acquired this, or even 4 years ago when we first acquired it, was a metal that not many people knew much about. And the narrative, as I mentioned, is really, really starting to change here. And the main reason for that is the use of tungsten within the military. So it's the hardest, or one of the hardest metals on the planet, and has the highest melting point. So because of those really unique thermodynamic properties, it makes it almost irreplaceable in a lot of modern kind of defense technology. So that's probably the main driver right now. But I think longer term, you know, tungsten is being used in a lot of really interesting and unique green technologies, you know, nuclear fusion being one of them. It's probably going to be one of the most important input metals into that technology. So military demand probably in the short term is really driving things, but longer term we see it as a metal that's going to really help power this kind of green revolution, which is really exciting for us.
Okay, now you were doing some work on the project, and one of the drill holes gave you some pause for a moment to take a look at what was inside. You actually brought a consultant to further the story along. So I'll let you pick it up from there and talk to you about what you saw within this drill hole that really sort of launched what the next phase of exploration is going to look like.
Yeah, no, of course. Great question. So I think just a bit of context here is helpful. And it's what we're looking at Pilot Mountain are these kind of at surface tungsten skarns. So for listeners that know what a skarn deposit is, it's hosted within sort of limestones and carbonate rocks. But when you have a skarn deposit, geologically, it needs to be associated with some sort of heat source. And most oftentimes, that's sort of a nearby what's called a porphyry or a causative porphyry. And I'm sure porphyry is probably a term that a lot of your listeners are well acquainted with. Reason being, porphyry deposits are some of the most important sources of metals like copper in the entire world. So when we acquired this project about 4 years ago, you know, the at-surface tungsten skarns were really important, as I mentioned, because of hosting the largest tungsten deposit on U.S. soil and really the value that we could add as we push that particular deposit forward through PFS and into construction, hopefully, was taking a step back and saying, well, maybe there's a much bigger story here. We have, you know, four tungsten skarns at surface, but no one's ever really kind of gone and looked for the heat source or the causative porphyry. So being an exploration geologist myself and someone who's really focused most of my career on porphyry exploration, we had a different lens than the previous operators and explorers on that property had. So we found just sort of south of our main tungsten deposit there, a really interesting geophysical anomaly. And so we went in and drilled it. And sure enough, pretty much from surface down to just over 400 meters, we found some really, really interesting porphyry-style alteration and mineralization. So we brought in Dr. Carter, who's an expert in porphyry exploration within the Yerington district where we're operating in Nevada. And sure enough, you know, having him get his eyes on the core and do some further work kind of in the field really confirmed what we thought, which was this looks to be potentially quite exciting. So that's what we're doing now is the porphyry exploration. That's sort of a side to the work we're doing at our skarn deposit at surface. But with Dr. Carter now finished that work, we're now kind of taking all the results in and figuring out where to drill next within what looks to be a potentially really exciting system here, which would be sort of an addition and a bonus to what we have at surface with the tungsten skarns.
Yeah, you've done some extra geophysical work and all that kind of stuff. So that data is all expected to be released sometime in the next little while and give you sort of a roadmap for what you're going to be doing in the future.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's going to be a very news-rich period over the next probably 2 to 3 months here, not only with drilling results and further updates from the drilling program that's ongoing, but we'll certainly be talking about the holes that we're going to permit into this newly discovered porphyry system. And then obviously once we get those drills started, what we're going to find in those. So as I mentioned, the great thing about this porphyry is it's just a bonus right now. There's a lot of value that exists with our tungsten skarns at surface. And as I mentioned, importance for U.S. national security. But this is going to be something that we're going to continue to push here and drill and look to explore and see what the real potential is here, which is really exciting.
Yeah. So Oliver, I mentioned you're at our OTC studios in New York City. Obviously, you mentioned you're upgrading on the listing there, but also I guess you're trying to get awareness of what the company's up to and the work that you've done, and that's obviously really important as sort of the next phase of the story.
Yeah, absolutely. So as I mentioned, we are a UK domiciled company. The first year of our kind of public company life was focused on really building the story in the UK, and with the retail and institutional investors there. And we've certainly done that. We've had a lot of success with our UK listing. But as I mentioned, all of our operations and exploration is done in the state of Nevada, and in particular Pilot Mountain, with the very strategic nature of that asset owning, with the largest tungsten deposit, as I mentioned, on US soil. We're now maybe not shifting focus, but we're really trying to emphasize our US listing now, and really growing this story to the average kind of US retail investor. And the reason being, it's a story that I think really resonates with most US citizens, which is the onshoring and reshoring efforts to bring the critical mineral supply chains back onto US soil. They've been pushed off to some of the unfriendly adversaries. But now in 2024, it's so important that these supply chains come back on the US soil. And for metals like tungsten, it's really probably near the top of the list in terms of metals that we need to bring back and start to reduce our dependence on countries like China, who currently dominate the tungsten supply chain. So the efforts that we're doing here and pushing this project forward in the state of Nevada is really important. And as I mentioned, really important to, I think, US retail investors. So the UK, marketing that we do will continue, but we'll certainly add on another layer here as we look to push our US OTC listing here and really grow the narrative here in the US.
Absolutely. Very critical, as you mentioned. Oliver, thank you so much. Great to see you, and good luck with everything. We look forward to continuing to follow the story, okay?
Yeah, thanks so much, Steve.
All right, there's Oliver Friesen, the
Cheers.
CEO of Guardian Metal Resources.